Hello, my name is Ruth, and I am your AI voiceover companion for this video. Today, I am going to show you how to operationalize your AWS WAF logs with Amazon Security Lake. Amazon Security Lake recently announced the expansion in log coverage support for AWS Web Application Firewall logs. This video will show you how to operationalize AWS WAF logs by centralizing them into Amazon Security Lake and analyzing your multi-account and multi-region WAF traffic using AWS analytics tools such as Amazon Athena and Amazon Quicksite. Amazon Security Lake centralizes security data from AWS environments, SaaS providers, on-premises, and other cloud sources into a purpose-built data lake stored in your account. It simplifies log aggregation, normalizes data into the Open Cybersecurity Schema framework, and allows you to analyze your data with your preferred analytics tools. AWS WAF is a highly configurable and scalable cloud-native web application firewall that helps protect web applications from application DDoS, web, and bot attacks by allowing you to configure rules that allow, block, or monitor web requests based on conditions that you define. AWS WAF can be deployed to protect resources such as Amazon CloudFront, application load balancers, Amazon API Gateway, as well as AWS AppSync. AWS WAF logs include information about the traffic that is analyzed by your web ACL, such as the time that AWS WAF received the request from your AWS resource, detailed information about the request, and the action for the rule that each request matched. To monitor web traffic cross regions and cross accounts, and to create dashboards from AWS WAF ACL logs such as this one, customers normally need to centralize their logs in a centralized location. There are a few ways that this can be accomplished. One of the easiest ways customers can choose to centralize their AWS WAF ACL logs is to centralize logs using AWS Firewall Manager to an Amazon S3 bucket for analysis and visualization. The following steps are usually required. Customers set AWS Firewall Manager to retrieve AWS WAF ACL logs from all accounts in an organization to a centralized account. Note that AWS Firewall Manager is region-specific, so logging cross-region WAF ACL logs requires customers to deploy AWS Firewall Manager in multiple regions. Create Amazon Data Firehose in each of these regions, and then centralize these logs in a target Amazon S3 bucket. Best practice includes encrypting this bucket. Customers also need to ensure that they have the right IAM and Amazon S3 bucket policies to enable them to configure centralized logging. Customers can then use Amazon Athena to query these logs in the centralized S3 bucket. For performance and cost reasons, customers are encouraged to partition their AWS WAF ACL logs for queries. This normally involves customers having to perform additional manual steps such as setting up AWS Glue resources, including Glue data catalog tables for schema management. Once this is done, customers can then use tools like Amazon Quicksite to visualize this data. The second option, and the focus of this video, is to centralize AWS WAF ACL logs through Amazon Security Lake. Amazon Security Lake provides the following benefits: enabling comprehensive cross-region and cross-account log aggregation and collection. With just a few clicks, Amazon Security Lake can be deployed to automatically centralize all AWS WAF logs cross-accounts and cross-regions into Amazon S3 buckets. This is a significant benefit, as it streamlines the process for cross-account and cross-region log management. Secondly, it reduces the operational overhead of creating and managing manual data lakes. Amazon Security Lake automatically creates the following resources for you: encrypted Amazon S3 buckets and the IAM permissions necessary to centralize your logs. It turns on logging in the back end so that you no longer have to create data pipelines manually. It also deploys an AWS Lambda function to perform ETL jobs on raw WAF ACL data to the Open Cybersecurity Schema framework and transforms logs into Apache Parquet format. AWS Glue resources, such as AWS Glue data catalog tables and AWS Lake formation tables, that contain information about data from each source, including schema, partition, and data location information. Subscribers, for example, Amazon Athena, have the option to consume data by querying these lake formation tables. Amazon Security Lake has adopted the Open Cybersecurity Schema Framework, which is a standardized and extensible schema for cybersecurity data. OCSF addresses the challenges of data integration, observability, and consistency. All AWS logs that is supported by Amazon Security Lake, including CloudTrail logs, VPC flow logs, Security Hub findings, WAF ACL logs, and many more, are automatically transformed into OCSF. This means that customers are able to run complex queries across different AWS logs without having to manually transform the data. For example, customers could run a query to understand if AWS WAF has successfully blocked a port scan attempt from a malicious actor through querying both Amazon GuardDuty findings via AWS Security Hub findings and AWS WAF ACL logs. Amazon Security Lake also integrates with multiple third-party providers that can send data or receive data to or from Amazon Security Lake in OCSF and Apache Parquet format. Some of these partners can be seen on screen. OCSF provides the ability to standardize all logs, regardless if it's on-premise, AWS logs, SaaS application logs, or other clouds, to allow customers to enhance visibility across all tools and environments, accelerate threat detection and response, and streamline security operations. AWS WAF logs are typically a voluminous log source. Many customers don't want to retain AWS WAF logs in a SIEM tool long-term due to costs associated with storing these logs or due to licensing concerns. Oftentimes, this could lead to blind spots in their security analysis. Amazon Security Lake separates the data storage layer from the analytics layer, allowing customers to retain the logs long-term in cost-effective Apache Parquet GZIP format within Amazon S3 out of the box. This delivers up to 90% compression ratio and saves on storage costs long-term. Customers can use their preferred analytics tools to query and analyze this data. For example, you can use Amazon Athena or other supported partners to perform query in place, or federated search and analytics to reduce data transfer out costs from your security lake. Normal best practices for cost optimization on S3, such as applying S3 lifecycle management rules, can also be applied to further optimize costs. Integrating AWS WAF ACL logs with Amazon Security Lake is simple and can be done with just a few clicks. Let me show you how. This demo assumes that you have already created the necessary IAM permissions and assigned a delegated administrator for your organization for Amazon Security Lake. A guide to get started with Amazon Security Lake will be provided in the description of this video. To enable AWS WAF logs integration, head to the Amazon Security Lake console. Amazon Security Lake allows you to ingest the AWS default sources or ingest specific AWS sources. In this example, I will select AWS WAF. Next, Amazon Security Lake allows you to ingest data from selected regions. You can choose to ingest logs from all supported regions or only specific regions. In this example, I will select US East 1 and US West 2. You can then select which accounts you would like to collect AWS WAF logs for. You can specify all accounts in your AWS organization, specific accounts in your organization, or only a single account. You can also allow Amazon Security Lake to enable Security Lake for new organization accounts. This means that whenever an AWS account is added to your organization, Amazon Security Lake will automatically enables the collection of AWS WAF ACL logs in the regions and accounts that you have chosen. Next, you can choose to aggregate data from contributing regions to a single region for data residency requirements, as well as select storage classes for cost optimization. In this demo, I will select my contributing region to be US West 2 and my rollup region to be US East 1. You can transition your logs to a lower cost S3 storage class for cost optimization. For example, you can choose to send all log data to S3 Intelligent Tearing after 90 days, send logs to Glacier Deep Archive, or expire the logs after a certain period. When I click Create, Amazon Security Lake begins creating all resources necessary to centralize AWS WAF logs into Amazon S3 buckets that customers fully own and control. Now that my AWS WAF ACL logs are centralized, I can use Amazon Athena to easily run queries on my Glue data catalog tables, such as this query that allows me to find denied requests for AWS credentials over the past 7 days. I can then further investigate the results of this query to understand whether this activity is unauthorized or if there are issues with my application that need troubleshooting. I can also visualize my AWS WAF ACL data by creating a dashboard using Amazon Quicksite. A link to a blog post on how to visualize Amazon Security Lake findings with Amazon Quicksite will be posted in the description of this video. In this example, I have stood up an Amazon Quicksite dashboard that shows me web traffic across all of my AWS accounts in my AWS organization. I have created examples that look at top rules, blocked by account ID, requests terminated by AWS managed rule groups over time, top 10 allowed IP addresses, top 10 blocked IP addresses, top denied and allowed source IP addresses by country, top URLs blocked by AWS managed rule groups, and top URIs accessed. This current view shows me all web traffic across my AWS accounts in my organization. As Amazon Security Lake centralizes all AWS WAF ACL logs in my account, I can now also drill down per account ID to understand my web traffic in a single account. For example, this visualization now shows me the same dashboards, but for a single account. This allows both network and security teams to derive security insights across their organization without the challenge of siloed visibility. Amazon QuickSight can also create insights such as this ML-powered anomaly insight. For example, I can see that an anomaly was detected on July 27, 2024, at 3 a.m., primarily driven by a higher-than-expected hourly total count of blocked records for the AWS Managed Rule Group for known bad inputs and the AWS Managed Rule Group for the Linux rule set. I can then run further analysis to understand the root cause. With Amazon Security Lake, customers benefit from optimized log retention, managed data lifecycle policies, reduced time taken to manage data pipelines, deriving faster insights, and simplifying security operations. Centralizing AWS WAF logs with Amazon Security Lake allows customers to create multi-account and multi-region dashboards for comprehensive web traffic analysis. Customers can try Amazon Security Lake for 15 days at no cost with any new AWS account. If you would like to learn more about what was shared today, contact your AWS account team or engage a security specialist by emailing us directly at awsdetectionandresponse@amazon.com. Try Amazon Security Lake for free in your account today. Thank you for watching.